Bellary, known as the Steel City of Karnataka, is located 311 kilometers from Bangalore. It is characterized by hot and dry climate. It is known for its mines and factories. Both natural resources like granite stones from mines and processed goods like steel and cement are available in abundance. It is also featured with rocky and undulating terrain. The site is located 5 kilometers away from Bellary, along State Highway 128, Talur Road. Taking a deviation, we arrive at the school Pupil Tree, which is known for its unique way of construction.
So we wanted to know how was this concept derived? Like why a school up in our school?
It was started actually there in 2001. Look around. Imagine a glass tower in the middle of nowhere, rolling. It's not environmentally sustainable. The weather conditions, wind conditions, heat. But if you take something which people have been living here and have perfected it over thousands of years, build something which reflects this town, this village. The second reason is we wanted to create schools not as something which has a clinical nature. Create a school which is more organic. Then the third thing was telling that you should provoke thinking. The fourth reason for us was environmental sustainability. We are very deeply and we feel we should go a little bit further by keeping it using as much environmentally sustainable products which are carbon neutral. So we try to make it as much carbon neutral as possible. Carbon neutral, less processed and more natural. So that is one of our key features in this world.
So what is the briefing you gave to the architect regarding the sourcing of materials?
So I gave a brief to the architect. 100 kilometers from here, 80% of our product will be within 100 kilometer radius of Bellary. Look at there is a 20% market in the Sigal. But it fits, we got around the area, 120 kilometers. Some we got from Chittoor, Chalukya, that is also 100 kilometers. These tiles we purchased from Shaba. And Kadapa is also nearby to us. So we lot of Kadapa. Our slabs. Then that red ones in that group. That is called Macharla. Macharla, Betam Charla. They are all next to each other. So we Betam Charla we used in that oral. Macharla red stones I used. Shabad, some polished, some unpolished.
So and the doors, so the timber?
Doors, the timber, what we did was that is all jungle wood. One of the forest department auctions, the place called Mundugod, which is about 160 kilometers from here, Dharwad district. And we took the jungle wood and gave a treatment like antique. Treated that with the castor oil.
So then those rubber stones.
Until Bellary, you get size stone. Quarries are not there. So what people did, whatever stone is available, whichever farm, whether it is in the riverbed or in their farm, or in some discarded place, some jungle, they just carried it and built the way it was, without dressing it.
So how was the interpretation of the design made?
Her name is Ami Mehta. She lived in Bellary for 1 year to build this campus. So I took them to Sandur area, this Belgal area, Kabgal area. So when I showed her, said, why can't we revive this? You use it. Everybody stopped building. Then we found out somewhere, Bijapur, Maharashtra border, they still had that tradition. The masonry was in training course. They didn't know how to build it. They were trying to build it like a brick wall, layer by layer. The mason himself will choose what's the correct, because he will see which proportion where it sits. So every mason became a designer. A building no more becomes a building, becomes a piece of art. Because everybody has contributed to this. She had to create a teamwork. So everybody worked like a team. Entire structure, 8 months we created. We don't have like expertise here. So we got guys from Bangalore, Mangalore city. So carpenters, we don't have great expertise there. We got from Tamil Nadu, who came and fixed it. The thatch work actually, what you saw there outside, the dance hall. The thatch work, there is one in 40-50 kilometers from here, there are these camps called Bengali camps. The Bengali refugees, they are very expert at thatch work. The mud walls, what were created, we got guys from a place called Royal Padu. some domes got created. We don't have expertise in creating domes.
All exposed brick. In fact, it's inside hut room. Hut masonry inside.
Regarding financial cost also, did you give any constraint to the architect?
I have this much money to spend. I will take and work around it. You won't believe, cost of construction was 280 rupees per square feet.
So according to you, for a new age school to be built in a proper city, how much would it cost?
Nowadays, the same architecture out there, 2000 bucks.
Sir, how is the maintenance taken care of?
Yes, there is a lot of maintenance because these are handmade. They're using natural material. They're not perfect industry. You have to maintain it.
Sir, then how far is the social impact that is created by the school on society?
Anyways, first of all, you are directly touching the lives of children. Are they not part of society? So design itself is having a social impact. It's much cooler for us. So directly there's an impact on nature for us because we use less ACs and less fans, and it's much cooler place in summer. So it's not just buildings, it's also environmentally sustainable, cost advantages. Power is a very big thing nowadays.
ప్యూపిల్ ట్రీ స్కూల్ ఉంది కదా, అది రాకుండా ముందు ఇదంతా డెవలప్మెంట్ అయిన
భాగం,
ల్యాండ్ వాల్యూ అంత పెరగడం.
ఏమంటారు పెద్దలు, ఈ రోడ్ మాత్రం వాల్యుయేషన్ ఉండదు అని చెప్తారు.
వాల్యుయేషన్ వచ్చిందా?
అరకులు వచ్చిండేది, బాలభారత్ వచ్చిండేది, ఇది వచ్చిండేది, ఎస్ఆర్కే నగర్ వచ్చిండేది. ఆ డెవలప్మెంట్ లో బాగుండదు తాళ రోడ్ అంటారు. అంతే
regarding the like temperature, you know, see, because Bellary is a hot place.
Very hot.
Yeah. Then in the previous school, do you used to feel the same temperature in the previous school and this school?
No, here a lot of cold ambitions. Yeah. Get more related cool air.
Okay.
మళ్ళీ ఇప్పుడు అది స్కూల్ వచ్చినాక నుంచి ఇక్కడ చుట్టుపక్కల అంతా బాగా డెవలప్మెంట్ అయింది.
అయింది కదా, ఈడ ప్లాట్ అయింది, ఆడ ప్లాట్ అయింది, ఇక ఈడ ప్లాట్ అప్ బాగా డెవలప్మెంట్ అయింది.
డెవలప్మెంట్ రోడ్లు అవన్నీ
బాగానే
బాగా.
Pupilry belonging is unrestricted. Pupilry school as envisioned by the client and the architect with the help of skilled labor and many other social factors has evolved to be an apt example for revival of native traditions and has created an environmental impact and awareness amongst the people. This free-flowing space dotted with cluster of buildings questions conventional practices. The clear application of native principles is apparent and obvious in many ways.